Hi, let's look at some stocks here. I got my list of stocks that I watch frequently, sorted by top losers here today. And I'm looking at Twitter, which just took a big gap down here. we had this major top up here at about $80 and couldn't get there again. It looks like we formed sort of a head and shoulders top here. Price traded back down into the cloud, which indicates indecision. So, leading up to the earnings event or whatever happened here, the market was undecided whether the uptrend could continue trading inside the cloud. And now we've definitely broken down below. Looks like we've traded right down to an area of support based on this previous peak right here. I'd be looking for that to hold if you're trading this. I think the next area of good support could be down in here around $45. All right, IDEX. This has had a bit of buying action recently. Looks like an oversold bounce to me in a long-term downtrend. We're starting to react to a downtrending Ichimoku cloud here. On a positive note, we have gotten above the Kijunsen line here, but we've seen that before, as in right here, and we traded back down. One interesting thing is on the long-term chart, I kind of see this rising channel here. Seeing take some pretty volatile swings, and then price action can burn off for months. So it looks like to me we're going to keep trading down. We may get a reaction down here at the bottom of this channel. Could take quite some time, but it looks like somewhere around $2, 250, depending on how long it takes to get there. So SOS. Some of these charts look like they're trying to find a floor, but we still have a lot of downtrending pressure. It's going to take a lot for price to escape this downtrending pressure, especially with a cloud that thick. And then, of course, by then we're getting too close to the previous top, and so. I think the bottom fishers are going to keep trying, but there's likely to still be selling pressure. When I look at the long term on some of these charts and think about how far down these could go, they could continue down for quite some time. So I have this descending trend line I've drawn here. We're staying below that. And then DM, you can see here we reacted to downtrending pressure from the 50 moving average, which is across the 100 now. We've got the 200 way down here. Looks like price kind of reacted there. So some of these you have to see which is stronger, the 200 moving average or this downtrending pressure we see. And as I've said before, these chart patterns can take quite a while to work themselves out. I like to look at a long-term picture sometimes on these. It's a 10-year chart. So when you think about how far down these could go and how long they could continue down, there's really no end in sight in some of these from what I see. It just depends on market sentiment and how strongly people believe in a turnaround of fundamentals and whatnot. CCIV, we're still trending down below this trend line that I've drawn here. AESE, definitely turned bearish here. We're below the cloud and we've got a downtrend in Kijunsen coming in to push the price down here. this had been maintaining a decent uptrend until recently. Here we had a TK cross. Price has gotten above the Tinkinson here and it's trying to recover. But we'll have to see if price can continue to be supported by Tinkinson here. We get another TK cross going up. Oh, that could turn around. CAN, Canon Incorporated. Let's take a look at the long term. How far down could it go? Well, there's really no support in this steep uptrend here. We're trying to find support from our moving averages. I'm seeing more and more of those failing. So this could come back down to $5-6 here. It's another 50% drop from where it is now. Sundial, SNDL, trying to find a floor here. We kind of have this bit of a support area here at 75 cents, 80 cents. We'll have to see if that can hold. Here's the 200 moving average. It's getting pretty flat and the other moving averages are trending down. Fuel cell. This has actually been one of my favorites to short sell. And I just got back into this one here. After this pullback here near the descending trend line I've drawn. So another long-term look. How far down could it go? Well, all the way down, possibly. I don't like charts that look like this. I think people thinking these are going to go to the moon or live in a pipe dream, but... So I pointed out months ago, we had this descending pattern here. I drew this trend line and we actually reacted before we got there. So how far down could they go? Well, they could go down for quite a ways. We have some support right here that's trying to hold. We're going to go down and test it again, it looks like. We need to see some sort of meaningful bottoming action in these, which I don't see yet. BNGO. We're reacting to downtrending pressure once again on this. People get excited about these moves here and they jump back in, but a lot of them are blind to this descending downtrending pressure we have from the cloud and our other indicators here. It's good to use your technicals to be able to see these things because they do work right up until they don't. I mean, eventually at some point price can get above the cloud, but this is a very thick cloud right now. It takes time for these chart patterns to evolve and work themselves out. See the cloud thin out and price begin to enter it and ultimately break back through it. Let's see, 10-year zoom out on this. Looks like we can't even go 10 years. This is the IPO, I guess, is September of 2019. So we got back above the previous high here. And how far down could it go? Well, I don't know. As I said before, possibly all the way down. $1 maybe. So that's about a 75-80% loss from here. This thing's kind of been on fire. CLOV, Clover Health, but we're still below the, we've entered the cloud, but we're still below the cloud here, and you can see how it reacted right here at the top of the cloud. Give it time. There may be some support now from the top of this newly forming green cloud here. And it actually looks like the bottom of this bottom area of this cloud here is our main support right down here, so that's about about $9. And we traded up to 12 and got rejected here. So I would give that some time, maybe look to get in around $9 and watch for price to ultimately break above the cloud here and form a green bullish uptrending cloud. Let's look at Gevo. A little bit of an oversold bounce. Downtrending pressure from our key adjustment is right here. And we've got a downtrending 50 moving average now. This is a trend line up here I drew on a long-term chart, like a 15-year chart. I pointed this out months ago before the trend rolled over, that this has been a very long-term bearish trend. People insist the fundamentals are turning around, which, you know, maybe they are, but price is truth, and the trend line, the descending trend line is currently intact. So I'm not liking long positions in this right now. How far down could it go? Way down. It could go way down. Let's see. Maybe down to about $3. See if it can hold $3. There's quite a bit of price action right in here before this big drop. So yeah, that's another 50-60% drop from here. Just a lot of risk in these right now. They just went up so much so fast. People that managed to get in early on these rallies should have taken their profits way up here when our moving averages crossed. Definitely when we fell below the cloud here. NKLA, this has been a very long-term downtrend. It's another example when I say how far down could they go, and I say all the way down. This thing has pretty much gone all the way down. And I just could continue this basically what looks like a V-fib here. yeah, so I'm not liking that either. This has also been a great one to short sell. After we got rejected at the top of the cloud here. BB BlackBerry, it's trying to wake up some here, but I don't see it going anywhere. Too much downtrending pressure in this as well. Long-term trend, don't like that chart. This was a major selling opportunity if you've been, for people, other buyers that have been waiting in this for a long time. We had a big flush here. A lot of shares let go. And with the COVID crash here, and then a big run up, big selling opportunity, it looks like to me. FUBO, plenty of downtrending pressure there. All right, let's get to some some crypto related stocks. Let's see. RIOT, sort of trading in the descending channel here. We bounced from the bottom of the channel and come back up to test this area here. I believe these are going to be in rolling over in a long-term downtrend. BLOK, sort of in this consolidation pattern here. But the cloud is twisting and turning red. So I'd be watching this to see if price breaks down below the bottom of this channel here. I think this has quite a ways to drop if and when that happens. Coin. Not enough chart information yet, but we're definitely in a descending pattern here. Let's look at a 30-minute chart. 30-minute chart. Price is trying to stabilize here. We're kind of forming a floor here at about 292, 293. Pretty bullish candle here when we trade it all the way down to 280, 282. Go back to our daily chart. CHPT. This stock moves with some pretty strong price action. We've responded from this area a couple times here pretty strongly, but we're still making lower highs and reacting to downtrending pressure here. I think if this area breaks here at this 1950 next level, looks like $16, $14. How far down could it go? Well, it's another one that's basically flatlined before this thing woke up. Clear down here at $9, $9.90, and we'll call it $10. So $10 is another 75% drop from here. NEO tried to take off and ran into problems with the cloud here, downtrending pressure. Trying to hold the 200 moving average. So we're getting in a pinch here with this. Either we're going to defeat the cloud or we're going to break the 200 moving average here. And also we have this support area that I've drawn out. So like I've said before, it can take quite a bit of time for these stock patterns to work out. So things are going to start getting more confined with the support and downtrending pressure. We've got a downtrending 50 here we're kind of reacting to. So we'll see if we can start getting above these downtrending pressure areas or if we're going to break down further. This potentially, the selling pressure could go on for a long time. All I'm getting is history back to September of 19, so no telling how far down this could go. Plug Power. Another one looks like it has a long way to fall, potentially. So yeah, I would just be avoiding these or shorting them. This one I took interest in recently, MSTR. Turns out this is crypto related. The company's invested heavily into Bitcoin. So if you believe Bitcoin's rolling over, which right now is a little bit undecided. So I see this support area right here. I've been watching at around $610. But we do have downtrending pressure. So I'm more in favor of shorting this, but I'm leery of this support area right here currently. Waiting to see if that's going to break down. If that breaks down, our next good support's down here at about 350 to 325 area. Snapchat, we're back up to the top of our consolidation range here. Let's look at a longer term. We had this nice V-shaped bottom here. And more consolidation and then a breakout. But we are seeing this this topping action here. We'll have to see if price can get back above this consolidation area and start heading up to new highs. But right now, I'm not liking this chart pattern much. QS, Quantum Space, Quantum Scape. I'm actually shorting this one. We had this area of support here that broke. And I'm looking for prices to stay below that and begin reacting to the downtrending key to send line here and cloud. GNUS, Genius Brands, this chart's kind of a hot mess. Kind of broken down below this trend line that I'd drawn here. And we've got some downtrending pressure coming. I'm not really liking this chart. I do have some position in this, but I sold the majority of it when we took this big spike up over here. One of these big spike ups. Let's look at DraftKings. This DraftKings rally seems to be deteriorating a bit, but this has been a nice little longer term rising trend here. I believe at some point buyers are going to come rushing back in, and I got a support level I've drawn here at about $55. This whole area here is kind of a range of support, so I do see a lot of support for this stock between $49 and $55. We'll just have to see where we can get back above our Kijunsen here and be supported by our bullish indicators, like we see here with the Tinkinson above the Kijunsen. Right now it is looking bearish. PLTR, this chart's been interesting. We've got this area of support here that's been holding, but we have downtrending pressure. So it's going to be interesting to see which takes precedence here. If we're going to break down, my suspicion is this is going to break down below this support area here. I don't see a lot of support over here. I don't see a lot of chart history to give us support, so it's hard to tell where this is going to go, but currently it just looks like a big head and shoulders top. Downtrending pressure. So I did take a long position in this based on this support area here, and then I just took a little bit of profit because I'm not liking this pattern here. Tilray, looks like we're about ready to come into downtrending pressure again on this. Another one I look at a long-term perspective, how far down could we go? Well, it could go a long ways down. No telling where this selling pressure is going to end. This thing has been in a, this kind of reminds me of this move here, see? And look how far, look how long this thing sold off. Big oversold area here. Yeah, so it's difficult to tell where the bleeding is going to stop with these things, but right now it just looks all bad to me. All right, back to Roblox. Not enough chart history to really give us much information, but we seem to be kind of range bound here. I'd be looking to buy this around $64, $65, and look for that area to hold. All right, so that's it for now.